Who here on keto is sick of eggs? Nothing wrong with them, but I'm just getting a little bit tired of having them in the morning every single day. All right, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna give you four different kinds of keto breakfasts. So we're gonna put a spin on breakfast. You don't have to just do eggs anymore. Although one of the options I am gonna give you is going to be a different spin on eggs so that you can get outside of that typical egg box and get a little bit more of a health benefit. Every single one of the foods that I am talking about today has a powerful effect on your body when it comes down to creating ketones and helping you burn fat, but also boosting cognitive function. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dive right into these dishes. You're tuned into the internet's leading performance, nutrition, and fat loss channel. New videos every single Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday at 7 a.m. Pacific time, and a bunch of other videos in between as well. Also, I wanna make sure you hit that subscribe button. Then after you hit the subscribe button, you'll notice a bell icon. If you turn on that bell icon, it's gonna turn on notifications so you know whenever I post a new scientific, educational video, or whenever I go live. All right, let's dive in. So the first thing I wanna address here is people just get tired of eggs. Usually when we think of keto, it's like, what can we have for breakfast? It's like, there's eggs, there's bacon, there's a protein shake. It's like, what do you have? And no one wants to just go and have like a chicken breast for breakfast. Like, that's just kind of weird. I mean, bodybuilders do it, but it's not the realistic thing to look at. So let's go ahead and let's break down these different dishes. So the first thing that I want to start with is an unconventional spin on eggs. So let's get this one out of the way. If you do want to keep eggs in your keto breakfasts, then this is what you're going to want to do. So I've got it laid out in front of me, and I'll tell you a little bit more how to make it. You're going to make it simple. All you are doing is utilizing one whole egg. And then the additional calories and the additional eggs, you're only going to use the yolk, okay? Literally, like one whole egg plus 2 to 3 yolks, depending on the size and weight that you are, okay? Realistically, if you're under 150 pounds, you're probably only gonna wanna do one whole egg plus 1 yolk. If you're 150 to 225 pounds, you might go ahead and do 2 yolks. If you're a little bit more than that, you might go ahead and do 3 yolks. No real reason to go much more than that. Here's the reasoning behind that. Okay, we want to keep this anti-inflammatory. So most people think that it's the yolk that causes the problem when it comes down to our health. The reality is, it's more likely to be the white. So when an egg is growing a chicken per se, the white has a lot of the hormones that we don't necessarily want to be ingesting. The hormones that could affect our metabolism and could affect our inflammatory markers within our body. The yolk, however, is essentially just the chicken. Okay, it's got the cholesterol, it's got some of the compounds that's going to be in a chicken, but the reality is that's where the good fats come from. So forget about the whole LDL cholesterol thing, because that's really a myth. And if we dive into that further, which I do in other videos, you realize that it's more about inflammation plus cholesterol that causes the issue. Okay, there are a lot of medical doctors out there now that say that really, truly, it's not the cholesterol. It's when you have high levels of inflammation in the body that causes the LDL receptor to become inflamed, that therefore catches the cholesterol, causes it to calcify, and then forms plaque or atherosclerosis. So in this case, we're doing the right thing. We're cutting out the inflammatory part, cutting out the egg white, and we're going with just the yolks. But we still have at least one whole egg, so we do get some of the benefit and some of the additional protein from the white. One thing you wanna remember when you are cooking these eggs is you wanna add the salt at the end, okay? Fun little pro cooking tip is if you add the salt at the end, it makes it so the protein doesn't denature and the eggs remain nice and fluffy. All right, let's go ahead and let's move in to dish number two. Okay, this one's a little bit more of an on-the-go style dish. Okay, what do you do when you're on the run? Sure, it only takes a couple minutes to whip up eggs, but again, we're talking about getting tired of eggs, right? You're on a keto diet, you're tired of having eggs every day, so you wanna do something different. We all know of bulletproof coffee or keto coffee or fat coffee, right? Okay, you take your coffee, you add a little bit of ghee in there, you add a little bit of coconut oil, you whip it up, you do all that fun stuff. Typical keto coffee, you can see my other videos on that. But what about adding some conditional proteins to it? So what I usually do is I usually take like a half scoop to a full scoop of pea protein, go ahead and add it into my coffee, and then I also add like a half a scoop of collagen, like unflavored collagen protein, and it makes it perfect. And then I whip it up, and I've got a bulletproof or keto coffee that has additional protein in it, so it's now a meal replacement. Okay, the nice thing is the ghee butter that we're putting into the coffee has so much power when it comes down to creating short chain fatty acids in our gut, we can really combat some negative things. So for example, the ghee is high in what is called butyrate. So that butyrate is a short chain fatty acid and it feeds the gram positive bacteria within our gut, which therefore makes it so that the lipopolysaccharides, which is a byproduct of negative gram bacteria, doesn't end up leaving the intestinal tract. Long story short, ghee has powerful, powerful brain-boosting properties and anti-inflammatory properties. So add some ghee, you don't have to add heavy cream, add your ghee, add your coconut oil, add your protein powders, okay? The cool thing is pea protein powder has just as much power as whey when it comes down to protein synthesis, so don't even worry about that. You don't wanna start your day with inflammatory whey. Okay, that's option number two. Now I wanna move into a completely different creative way of doing breakfast. And again, I'm just trying to open your eyes to different ways to do breakfast. I'm not telling you that one way is better than the other. I'm just trying to open your eyes a little bit. Let's do something different. Let's have some fun with this. So this one is where I'm taking either ground turkey, ground chicken, or some form of ground pork and seasoning it up like a breakfast sausage. So I could add some oregano, I can add some basil, I can add these things to make it taste sort of Italian and breakfasty. That's like what we really wanna do, right? You can go with a moderately fat meat here, no big deal. The next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take spinach. Okay, we're gonna take regular old spinach. I usually recommend just getting a microwavable or a frozen spinach that's already been wilted, already been steamed, and all you have to do is let it defrost or put it in the oven, put it in the microwave, whatever you need to do. Okay, then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take a non-dairy or dairy if you really want to, cream cheese, and you're gonna mix it up into the spinach and you're gonna make a very simple cream spinach. A little bit of cream spinach, like maybe a half a cup of cream spinach alongside like 3 or 4 ounces of ground chicken, ground turkey, ground pork, that's seasoned up right. Trust me, it ends up tasting like breakfast sausage along with a nice cream spinach that gets you your phytonutrients, gets you those greens first thing in the morning that you'd really want. And the cool thing is, you guys know that I'm a big fan of ButcherBox. ButcherBox is a special going on right now, just so that you guys know, with all of their breakfast items. So their breakfast link sausage, their breakfast pork sausage, their ground sausage, everything like that that fits right into this protocol. And there's a special link down in the description that'll get you a discount if you wanna jump on that. The cool thing about ButcherBox, literally cheaper than the grocery store, and you never have to leave your house. You just go online, you go ahead and you order your meat and they ship it. Grass-fed, grass-finished beef, we've got cage-free chicken, we've got everything that is exactly what we want to keep those omega-3 profiles right in check. So go ahead and check them out. So basically what you can do with this dish is you can either have the cream spinach on the side and go ahead and have your ground meat that's seasoned properly on the side, or you can mix it all up and make somewhat of a hash. Honestly, it tastes good either way. If you mix it up into a hash, it's perfect to eat on the go because the cream cheese kind of allows it all to stick together. Heck, you can even eat it in the car when you're on the run. So that's a perfect higher fat alternative to good old fashioned eggs. Okay, the last one that I wanna talk about is something really interesting. Okay, this is one that I created a while ago when I was craving hash browns. I was craving like the good old fashioned hashes that I would make with like hash browns and some bacon and things like that. And I was like, how do I get this same taste across? The cool thing is I found that literally by using rice cauliflower, so just good old fashioned cauliflower rice that you can get at any grocery store, putting it into a pan of some really thin sliced or really finely diced chicken breast or even ground chicken if you wanna go that route, and then mixing that up and then adding some bacon bits and then some seasonings to make it taste good and a little bit of coconut oil to add some fats, you end up with a perfect hash that is a great solution to getting over the boring aspect of eggs. So you're having something completely different, and if you want to, and you wanna add some more of the healthy fats into it, you can add the yolk of one egg. So if you do wanna have some eggs, but you don't wanna have a bunch of eggs, you just wanna add it in, get some extra fats, do that, add that extra yolk in there. Here's the cool thing about this breakfast. It's really good to start your day with things like cruciferous vegetables, even though they can be harder on the gut if you go overboard. The reason is because they're high in what's called indole-3-carbinol, which has a conversion process over to something called diindole methane, or DIM. Okay, what this does is it combats the 1,7-hydroestradiol. So basically it combats the estrogens that are bad within our body. So whether you are male or female, you want to combat that, especially on the male side, because your testosterone levels are peaking mid-morning. So if you can combat estrogen with this meal, by the time your testosterone levels start to peak, your estrogen levels would normally start to peak and you can nullify that a little bit, which means the testosterone is gonna be more bioactive in your body and it's gonna be able to do its job better. So very important there, and a nice little spin with this breakfast. So to recap, we've got eggs, okay? Simply one whole egg with some extra yolks. We've got a modified ketogenic coffee with some extra protein. Don't worry, that protein won't get denatured. The collagen is gonna be really good overall when it comes down to just satiety. Then we've got the ground meat, the ground turkey that's seasoned along with the cream spinach. And again, special offer from ButcherBox that you're not gonna wanna miss. Check it out down in the description. You're gonna get a bunch of free breakfast meats if you take advantage of that. And then of course, we have the cauliflower rice hash. Whole different spin on something you would get like in a skillet meal from Denny's, but without all the garbage, without all the omega-6 nonsense that's gonna make you feel like garbage. So Here we have it. 4 different keto breakfasts. And if you want me to do more videos like this surrounding the world of lunch, surrounding the world of dinner, maybe snacks, and get a little bit more hands-on and creative with my videos, make sure you let me know down in the comment section below, because you guys are driving the bus here. If you want this kind of content, I'm happy to do it. It's a fun little twist, and it gives you something practical and tangible that you can take with you day in and day out. So as always, keep it locked in here on my channel, and I'll see you in the next video.